and a very warm welcome back to the Audi Arena here in Győr, Hungary for the final day of competition at the Artistic Gymnastics Junior World Championships. This is the first ever such event, and what a success it has been so far. You join us on day four of the action with five final titles up for grabs. Well, here is the competition schedule for the day. As you can see, we start with the men's vault final, move to balance beam, parallel bars, the women's floor, and we conclude the day with a very exciting men's horizontal bar final. We are just a few minutes away from getting the first final underway. Here's the start list. Diogo Suarez will kick us off, finishing with Yang Haonan from China. It was interesting to know whether they'd prefer to go first and get it over with, or see what the others have done and wait till the end. Here is our first competitor, Diogo Suarez, representing Brazil. Double twisting Yurchenko for his first vault. Well completed. He was the sixth highest qualifier. That has a difficulty value, that vault, of 4.8. So a mark out of 10 for execution and 4.8 added on to the score. So really a maximum of 14.8 that he could achieve. Bronze all round at the Youth Olympic Games, silver on high bar and a silver on rings yesterday. Here lifting up into the double twist, wrapping in, just a little hop back on landing, but well controlled, straight in the somersault, keeping the feet together and then just bending the knees to land. A good start for him. And first vault scores 13.833. Twisting Sikahara, a 4.4 tariff attached to that vault. So a different approach. He can relax now, happy vibes all around. Two successful vaults. The judges will take care of the rest of it. Here we go, half turn on, wrapping into the twist. Just a small adjustment on landing. Quite central. Landing facing forwards, often difficult to control. He did a good job. Not as difficult as his first vault. Well executed. The second vault scores 13.666, giving him an average of 13.749. Our second competitor, Sam Dick from New Zealand. Ooh. And it's a big vault. He went for the difficulty. 2.5 twists off the top, a 5.2 difficulty value. So it's that risk versus reward. More difficulty, a big pace forwards. But explosive, pushing off the top, pulling into the twist. Right foot just stepping forward at the end there to control his momentum. 17 years of age. His older brother competed at the Gold Coast Commonwealth Games. So talent obviously running in the family. Placed fourth on vault at the Youth Olympic Games in Buenos Aires last year. So I'll be hoping to push up into the medals here. The first vault scores 13.966. We're ready now for the second vault. Landed. Good job. A handspring, 1.5 twisting, straight front somersault. That had a 4.8 difficulty value. So slightly easier, but well executed. Let's take another look. So here, forward entry, driving the heels up. Straight somersault, wrapping into 1.5 twists. Just a hop back. Good vault from Sandik. Opening the arms out to stop the twist. Focus on the landing. The second vault scores 14 marks exactly. He scores an average of 13.983, taking him into an early lead. The next gymnast represents Romania. Vera Petanetti. Romania renowned for its vaulters. Yes, a very nicely landed vault. Went for the same vault as Sandik for his first vault, that 5.2 difficulty. 2.5 twists off the top. With the leader coming into this final, but of course no carryover score. Have to do it all again, and that was a good start. You see determination, half turn on, wrapping in, and very nicely controlled landing. Super job. In trips on vault at the Youth Olympic Games. And the score comes in 14.516. Excellent start. His twin brother, Robert, competed at the Glasgow European Championships last summer. Prepares for another big vault. Oh, it's a huge vault. The handspring, double front in the top position, another 5.2. Really going for the difficulty. Congratulated by the coaches. Really nice atmosphere here. We can be pleased with that. Let's take another look at him in action. here. Handspring on. 2.5 rotations, pulling tight into the tuck. Just a step back. Just had to prevent himself from under rotating. Did a great job. Well, let's see what the judges make of it. He didn't want that extra step, but his gymnasts are after perfection. Second vault scores 14.333, giving him an average of 14.424. We have a new leader. This is our next gymnast, Jasper Smith-Gordon, 16-year-old from Great Britain, qualifying with the fourth highest score. Let's see what he has to offer now. Well, a very good first vault. Does the pace forward to control the landing again. 1.5 twisting Kazumatsu, the 5.2 difficulty value. There, turning on, wrapping into the twist, just a step to the side to control the landing. Complete focus in the approach. Nice line in flight, feet locked together, straight body position. The score coming through, 14.466. That's a good start for Jasper Smith-Gordon. Now, what can he produce for his second vault? The handspring, 1.5 twist in the straight body position. Cleanly through. A good job. 4.8 the difficulty value. And there, met by the coach Andrei Popov. Congratulated by all of the other nations. You must get to know each other on the circuit. Here's, I'm sure, World Championships. The junior first of many. Here, a recap on the vault. Focused in the approach, driving the heels, locking the feet together, straight body, and just a pace back, turned his body out a little bit just to control the rotation. The score coming through 13.9, giving him an average of 14.183, and a smile from Jasper Smith-Gordon, who moves into second place. Two more gymnasts remaining. Next up, from Brazil, this is João Vieira. Brazil, the only nation having two representatives in this vault final. Oh, very nicely done. He's happy with that, and you've done a good job. Lots of flight, very fast in the twist. Good first vault. Determination, half turn on, wraps in, pulls into the twist. Just a little adjustment on landing, but good vault from him. 4.8 the difficulty value for that. Qualified with a score of 13.933 and the score 14.166. has already improved upon qualification. Now then, concentration, and we're ready for the second vault. Well, again, going for the big handspring double front. He'd seen two of the gymnasts just sit down and under-rotate slightly. He had the opposite problem, just slight over-rotation. Bags of energy, bags of thrust. Just jumping forward on the landing, the hands went down. Very promising gymnast on this apparatus. Yeah, heels go up, pulling into the tuck. He opens out and just couldn't quite control the momentum. Such power, he was nearly off the end of the landing mat. The second vault scores 13.266, giving him an average of 13.716. So Bertinetti and Smith Gordon guaranteed a medal, but what colour will it be? One more gymnast to go. This is our final vaulter, Yang Haonan from China. Again, the 1.5 Kazumatsu, 5.2 the difficulty value. Nicely performed. Took a bronze medal on the rings yesterday. So talented. Let's take another look at the replay. Half turn, pushing in, wrapping in. 2.5 twists. It's 1.5 Kazumatsu as it turns out. Feet locked together. Nice form in the air. Arms come out to the side and just the pace. A good job from Yang. The score 14.5. Super second vault to boot. He'll be pleased with that. Surely enough to push into the medals. See. Feet go up. Straight somersault. 1.5 twists from the handspring. And his reaction said it all there, didn't it? Is happy to make a good landing. So what will it be? All eyes on the scoreboard. Our leader. ...14.424 the score to beat. And it's an average score of 14.3. He takes the title. Bertinetti takes the title from Yang in second place. Jasper Smith-Gordon takes a bronze. So there's the new world champion. I'll be celebrating in Romania tonight. So there, confirmation of the results. Gabriel Bertinetti, 14.424. The gold medal goes to him. Yang Haonan takes a silver for China. And Jasper Smith-Gordon wins a bronze for Great Britain. And the first apparatus will be the balance beam. Top eight gymnasts are making it through to the final. There's the start list. Top two qualifiers going in the first half of this final. The first finalist is Kayla Giacello from the United States of America. Flip on to the beam. Well, the triple and then the double. Difficult spins, crouch position. So far, so good. Change to rope. Quick layout, layout. She's working well. Holding to the dismount. Two backflips and a double tuck. Confident performance from the 15-year-old. The smile from her. Always a relief to get beam over with. She's pleased with that. Big smiles. She won the vault yesterday. She already has a gold medal in the bag. She took a bronze with the team. She's done herself no harm whatsoever with that beam exercise. Let's take another look at the start. Yeah. Three rotations, so difficult. She composes herself and then she does the same double to up the difficulty. There, the back flip and two layout somersaults. And then up into the double tuck to finish, and just a pace backwards. And a 5-4 difficulty value in qualification. And 13.366. Let's see what the judges make of it today. She's from Boyd's in Florida. And the score comes through 13.733. Great result from Kayla Giacello to get this beam final underway. And Next finalist is Wei Xiaoyan from China. Well, she did well there. Land off back clip on. And there's a slight correction in the air. Link, lay out some salt. Beautifully extended, lots of height. Lexington leaps into the Corbett flip. Well, that was a huge leap. Somersault. Full straight, 360 degree, full spin. And there's a sail. Round off. 2.5 twists. Another very nicely performed routine. Wei Xiaoyan. China took a silver medal in the team competition. She also won a silver on uneven bars yesterday. And a good routine from her. 14 years of age, 15 in August. This is the mount. Round off onto the board. And here, a backflip. She seemed to be slightly off center, but managed to pull her leg back online. She did very well indeed there. Able to correct herself. And here, big layout somersault. Such extension and amplitude. Chinese gymnasts renowned for their beautiful leaps on this apparatus. Yeah, making the connections. And building to the dismount, wrapping in 2.5 twists. Scored 14 marks exactly in qualification with a difficulty value of 5.6. The score comes through 13.733, the same score as Pelle Ticello. This is Yu Shan from China. Somersault. And knocked her confidence. Just to settle down a little bit there. Free walk over. Straddle and split jump. And the back flip. She has such amplitude in her movements. Again, the pause between what would usually be a connected set of leaps. Just a little hesitant. So high in releve, up on the toe in the full spin. And she's off again. Just not her day. What a shame. beautiful double twist to finish. Oh, but disappointment. The leader coming in. She is so lovely to watch. Exquisite extension, but two falls, it's not to be today. Consoled by her teammate. Years of age. She had a difficulty value of 5.9 in qualification. Let's take another look. Here's the mount. No problem there. Here's split change. Beautiful extension. And here, that's a cool but flip, but her hand slipped and she had quite a fall there. She did well to recover and continue. They're very resilient, these young gymnasts. And here, the dismount for double twist. Absolute pinpoint landing. Wait for the score to come through. And there it is, 12 marks exactly for Oyusha. Next on beam from the Russian Federation, Elena Gerasimova. Spring front somersault. Blue cart will lay out somersault. Had no problem there. Very confident. Into a rhythm now. Showing work low to the beam. We walk over leap into the half dozen backflip and another connection. Double spin in that crouch position. Builds up to the dismount. And a 2.5 twist and a lovely landing. And that's met with a big smile. A little leap from her, she knows she's done a good job. She really went about her job in an industrial manner, very workmanlike, committed and confident. Super routine. Qualified with a score of 13.566 in third place. Let's take another look. There's a handspring front somersault. Just a slight adjustment there. And the free cartwheel or aerial cartwheel into the layout. Very difficult combination. She made it look easy. And this was nice. Free walkover. Immediate split jump. Backflip with half turn and she put another jump on the end. And this was beautiful. Super landing, look at that. Not a waver. And Elena Gerasimova scores 14.2. She takes the lead. And that reaction says it all. She's delighted. And we're only halfway through. Coach thrilled with her performance. So these are the current standings. Elena Gerasimova leads at 14.2 from Wei Xiaoyang in China. Kayla DiCello currently in the bronze medal position. The next gymnast is Jennifer Gadirova from Great Britain. Two layout somersaults. Confident. And nicely through the dismount. And off 2.5 twists. Clean routine for Gadirova. Big smile from her. Silver medalist on the vault yesterday. She's had such a good competition here at these Junior World Championships. And she surprised herself yesterday. Here. Tuck back somersault on the beam. And this was a nice combination. Back flip two layouts. And here she moves into the dismount, the round off, up into 2.5 twists. Little pace there on the landing. Something. Seventh all around. Great result from her. There's our leader. 14.2. Super score from her. Jennifer Gadirova scores 13.133. Seems happy with that. The final competitor on beam representing Brazil is Julia Suarez. And that popular backflip mount. Into the two layout somersaults, but she's off. That was a shame. Shoulders weren't over her feet coming out of that. Costly one mark deduction for that. recovered since full well. Good posture. Two back flips, up into double pike. Well, a nice routine from her, but the fall will be costly. Realistically, unlikely to challenge for a medal, which is a shame. Some strong work from her, and certainly one to watch out for in the future. Big potential for them. Only 13 years old so far. She's 14 in August, born in 2005. Gymnasts have to be born in 2004 or 2005 to qualify or be eligible for these Junior World Championships. Some of our younger members there. This is the replay of the mount. Beautifully straight, extension right through to the tips of the toes. Into the split jump, immediate Corbett flick. And the two back flips, taking off 2 feet, pulling into the double pike. Strong work. Keep having to remind ourselves these are juniors. Give me a big smile. Julia Suarez scores 12.366, putting it into seventh place. So we can confirm. Here is our new world champion on the beam. Elena Gerasimova from Russian Federation takes the title. Wei Xiaoqian from China wins the silver. And Kayla DiCello from the United States of America picks up a bronze medal. Now let's see the men's throw. We start with the parallel bars. As a reminder of the start list. It's another year as a junior. First finalist is Ilya Kovtun, representing Ukraine. Up to handstand. This is our half turn. On to one rail. Lovely control. Small base of support into the Healy. Oh, very nice. Great control, no additional hand placements. And the double front, oh dear, what a shame. That was such a beautiful routine until the end. You see the desperation on his face there at the end. It had been clean, it had been composed. Very well executed. What a shame for Ilya Kovtun. Qualified in third place at 13.933. Let's take another look at this. Yeah. On the upper arms, that little rotation, swinging up into the handstand. It's a great line. Junior European champion. Took that in Glasgow in 2018. And look at that. Great work. No adjustments whatsoever. But this, unfortunately, is where it went wrong. Up into the two rotations, just opened out a little bit soon, and had to sit down. The score, 13.466. Next to go, Shinosuke Oka from Japan, the all-around junior world champion. Swinging well, barely needs to bend his legs at all, into the tip out. Right to the end of the rails. Oh, nice puff start. Extension right the way through to the toes. Squeezing the feet together. And the double front half turn out. No problem there. Another great routine from Oka. He seems to take it in his stride. It's quite a character. He'll just go through it as if it was in training. No big deal. With a real talent. Now he can catch his breath. Scored 13.633 in qualification. Here we see him locking out in the handstand. Beautiful line. Yeah, the other somersault, half turn. Long swing. And here, tip out to the end of the rails. Flexibility. Extension, and that's the Babsar. Judges looking for body to be up over the rails as they release there. Nice straight position. Yeah. 15 years of age. They turn 16 in October. And the score comes through 13.766. Taking an early lead, he's happy with that. Next gymnast is Christian Balázs from Hungary. Swirl into the tip out. Healy, it's going well. Healy in the Babsar. Squeezing the feet together in the handstand, keeping his line. Really little strength there just to readjust. And a double tuck to finish. He makes it through, Christian Balázs. Thanking the crowd for their support. and they appreciated his efforts. Qualified with the fourth highest score, 13.833, 17 years of age. Took a silver on floor at Buenos Aires in the Youth Olympic Games, a real talent for Hungary. Bronze on high bar. We'll see him perform there later on today. Again today. At the moment, it's all about the parallel bars. This was the start of his routine. The Hommer up into the handstand. Under somersault. Extending through the shoulders, swinging well into the tip out. This is good. Babsa. Leaving up to handstand. And this was the dismount. Double tuck, pulling in the knees. Just a pace foot. Crowd clapping along to the pulse. And the score 13.366. He moves into third place at the moment. Difficulty score 5.0. Next finalist, Yang Haonan, from the People's Republic of China. Under somersault to one. Ooh, some readjustments there. Oh. Drawing whoops of delight from the crowd, so high the buffs are rising right up above the rails. There, the tip out. Bags of time. Healy. And a double pipe to finish. Very nice routine. There was a slight error at the beginning, but some beautiful work. Yang qualified second with 14.266. Difficulty value of 5.3. Bronze on rings. Silver on vaults. Touch right in the end, keeping the feet and legs locked together. Look at this, look how high is the buffs are. Incredible. And again, swinging through, up into the tip out, such flight. Amplitude. And here's the dismount. Pulling into the pike position, two somersaults backwards, just a very small hop on landing. And the score 13.9. He moves into the lead with two more gymnasts to go. So there are the current standings. Yang leads from Oka Kovtun, currently in third place. finalist, Takiro Kitazono from Japan. Highest qualifier. Nice start. Yuli locking out in the handstand. This is a short half turn. Straddle front somersault. Lovely work. Can we tip out towards the end? It's going well. Again, the paths are building the difficulty. Good line. He's keeping his form. And a double front half turn out. That was a super routine. Well done, Kitazono. That must certainly challenge. Had a difficulty value of 5.7 in qualification. World champion with the team, world champion on pommel horse. Met by Oka and his other teammates congratulating him. He's done a good job. This was the start on the upper arm support. Forward somersault. Homma. Up into the handstand. Yeah. Keeping his form. Key two parallel bars. Not too many pauses. Not too many hand adjustments. He did very well indeed. That flying, impressive straddle somersault way above the rails. Every hand placement important. So much flight time. Yeah, building to the dismount. Driving the feet up, pulling up into the tuck. Half turn. Just catching the rail there, actually. Just at the end. No harm done, though. And the score coming through, 14.266. We have a new leader. Kitazono guaranteed a medal with one more gymnast to go. Our final gymnast is Li Hongyang from China. Work on the end. There's the tip out. Healy. Oh, little adjustment there. And the double pipe. Short and sweet. Li Hongyang, 16 years old. Part of the Chinese team. Placed fourth, the team, in their final. Japan winning gold, Ukraine second, and Italy third. Li scored 13.566 in qualification. Perhaps not as difficult as some of the others. He's happy to get through. Little fault there. Swinging. Upper arm back up. And here was the dismount, the double pike. Nice form. little hop, bending his knees at the end there. Big smile from Kitazono. Surely he's done enough. Lee Hongyan scores 13.066, putting him into sixth place. He seems happy with that. So, appreciation for all of the finalists on parallel bars. There is the new world champion. Takiro Kitazono takes the gold medal. Yang Haonan of China wins the silver. And Shinosuke Oka takes the bronze. Their confirmation of all of the results. Next, we'll be concentrating on the women's junior floor exercise final. The first gymnast is Silviana Sfiringu, representing Romania. The double spin at the start of her routine. Wrapping into the twist, the forward tumble at the beginning of her routine. Round off back flip into the full twisting double pike. Spins and leaps and turns, all adding to the difficulty. Whip back, okay. Triple twist, nice combination. Double pike, cleanly through the first competitor, 14 years of age, qualified in sixth place with 13.4. She's the reigning national champion. And, Romania was a team, were placed fourth. .9 separated all eight gymnasts from qualification. But, one gymnast was ahead of the rest. Here we see Sfiringu with the full twisting double pike. That was her second tumble pass. Really determined approach there. Wrapping into the somersaults. 2.5 twisting straight front. Nice work from her. And of course, artistry now playing such an important part in gymnastics. This is the whip back into the triple twist. A big emphasis on execution and artistry on floor now. And the score comes through 13 marks exactly. Well, here's our next competitor. This is Kayla DiCello from the United States of America. Oh, big opener, the flag's up, she's out of the area. One and a half. Into the two and a half. Nice second pass. Well, controlled spin. In the triple and the double, as we saw on beam. On screen, full twist in front. Working her way through the choreography. Taking a deep breath. Here she goes. Up into the double tuck, nicely landed. And well done, Kayla Di Cello. Strong performance from her. Shame about the step out at the beginning. Qualified with 13.266. A difficulty value 5.2. LeBron to the team. She took the title on vault. Bronze on beam. She's done very well. Let's take another look at her in action. That's the full twist in double tuck. Just a rebound and out of the area, unfortunately. There'll be a penalty for that. But she recovered well, got back on track. Here, really lovely run. One and a half twist, walk out into the round off backflip, up, wrapping in, two and a half twists. Good job. Favouring these spins, the squat position. Adding the forward tumbling, that's a handspring, full twisting straight front. Lifting up into the leaps. Really expressing herself. And no problem with the double tuck. Real up and coming gymnast. Move into senior ranks next year. The score comes through, 12.966. Penalty there, 0.3. Stepping out. Next to perform, Sky Blakely, representing the United States of America. And a big double straight to open. Impressive work from Blakely. And a full twisting double tuck. She's going well. This is a good routine so far. Double twisting front into the punch front, but out of the area. Nice interpretation of the music. Finishing up with a double pike, cleanly through. And finishing with a flourish, that was Sky Blakely. Big smile from her, an upbeat track, an upbeat performance. Hi, Blakely. Still 14. She doesn't turn 15 until next February. Dynamic approach to this tumble. Accelerating in the backflip, up into the double straight, holding the position. Just a step back to control the momentum. Some nice dance movements. Full twisting double tuck there. Strong tumbling. Some good leaps to match. This is a double twisting front, and there the step forward out of the area. Having to stay within this 12 by 12 meter perimeter can be quite tricky. And there's the final flourish to finish as she strikes a pose. And the score comes in 13.1. She takes the lead. Now, representing Great Britain, this is Jennifer Gadirova. Next, Jennifer Gadirova. She's such an expressive gymnast. A big double straight, nicely landed. Oh, she seems to be enjoying the dance. One and a half twist walk out into the double tuck. Good work. She's right in front of the judges and selling it to them as much as she can. Fast choreography. Has to be fit to keep up with it. Don't walk out. Into a two and a half twist. Well, an artistic performance from Jennifer Gadirova. Great job from her. Stylish. She had the acrobatic elements and the dance to match.
That's all right.
Scored 13.533 in qualification. Qualified with the fourth highest score. Lifting high into that double straight. Beautifully performed. Feet locked together. Artistic performer, so expressive. There's one and a half, walking out. She really did have to lift up into that double tuck there. Did a great job, just a step to the side. And here, the front somersault walking out into the backflip, wrapping up into the twist, two and a half. Jennifer Gadirova, 14 years of age. Promising gymnast. A twin is also with her here, Jessica Gadirova. Promising gymnast for the British team. They were joined by Ali Elite in the team competition. Won a silver on vaults. And the score, 13.266. We have a new leader. So he's happy with that. So, at the halfway point, Jennifer Gadarova leads with 13.266. From Skye Blakely from the United States of America, Silviana Sferingu, currently in third place. Next to perform will be Oh Yushan from the People's Republic of China. Twist to start. And she has the audience clapping with her already. Aye, up into the double tuck. Not a fault on landing there. Choreography matching the music. Two and a half twist. Punch front in the pike position and a big smile as she lands. Going for the triple spin. From Oh Yushan. Beautiful ankle extension. High five from the coach. A big sigh of relief there. She doesn't look 100% happy. I don't know if that's just the relief of getting through. Take another look at her in action. Here, yeah, round off, backflip. Triple twist. There's a step back there. Nothing major. This is a double tuck. Feet and knees locked together. Look at that. Pinpoint precision. Interesting choreography. Crowd enjoyed it. Here. Two and a half twist. Punch front in the pike position. And the final. Double twist. So easy. Beautiful ankle extension. In the leaps, taking the head right back. Finishing right in front of the head judge's desk. And the score 13.833. She takes the lead. She's happy with that little nod of approval. Next to perform, the highest qualifier and all-around junior world champion, Victoria Listanova. Two whipbacks into a triple twist. Well, if you want to make an impression, that's the way to do it. Split. Such flexibility. Mm-hmm. spin with the leg in horizontal. And a back flip up 2.5, straight front somersault. Well, she has everyone on her side here. Choreography to match the personality of the gymnast. Oh, what a performance! And what a competitor! Victoria Listanova, 14 years of age. It's really lit up this Audi Arena over the course of the last few days. What a talent! Super work from her. And difficult to boot. Let's see what the judges make of it, but surely that must be a challenge for the gold. Yeah, round off, whip back, another back flip, high up, wrapping in, three twists. Take that, she says. Choreography to match the acrobatic skills. Dynamic tumbling. 2.5 twists. Straight front somersault. Beautiful work and a big smile from her. She has the crowd behind her, entertaining them all the way. Beautiful choreography. Well, a gold with the team, a gold in the individual all around. Could it be another golden moment from Listanova? She seems to be enjoying it. And the score comes through 14.166. We have a new leader. Great score from her. So there are the current standings, and just one more gymnast separates Victoria Listanova from another world title, and it's her teammate. So the final gymnast in the women's program, Elena Gerasimova from the Russian Federation, takes to the floor. She chooses a tango to perform to. Oh, and the same tumble as her teammate. Two whips and the triple twist. Two and a half punch front in the tuck position. Double tuck. Modern music. Building into the final pass. Double twist. Beautifully performed. And there she finishes with the flourish. Yelena Gerasimova. There's no stopping the Russians. They've had a fabulous championship.
Being the last athletes in this
took the title on Beam. Scored 13.633 in qualification. Yeah, accelerating in the whip back somersaults. There's a backflip up into the triple twist. He just slightly crossed. Is she in the area? Well, the line judge will look after that. Double spinning split, just slightly off balance coming out. Two and a half punch front in the top position. Nice double spin. And there's a double spin to finish. Interesting. The sock is halfway off one of her feet. I don't know if that's a deliberate ploy or accidental. Didn't seem to do her any harm. And the score comes through 13.533. She moves into third place, taking the bronze medal. She's delighted. So there we have it. Victoria Listonova takes another gold. She becomes the junior world floor champion. Oh, Yushan wins the silver for China. Yelena Gerasimova takes bronze. Here, confirmation of all of the results. Two more medals for Russia. Coming up next, the men's junior horizontal bar final. Van Brunello, Wolf gymnast. They were in the final subdivision after a very long day of qualification, and it came down to floor routine. Final apparatus of these junior world championships is Ivan Girget from Russian Federation, about to start the routine. Over the bar. Nice form, shape of the body. And the straight catch air. Feet up together. And the straddle catch air. This is going well. Deep in. Half turn. Into the L grip. Flexibility of the shoulders required there. Just the dismount. Full twisting, double straight. Absolutely nails the landing. That is a good challenge. He's happy with that. Well done, Ivan Girget. He's proud of his performance there. Scored 13.166 in qualification. Clean, well performed. Yeah, you can see the dowels, the inside of the guard, just over the top, helps with the grip as well as the chalk. It's good line. Stylish performer. That's the straight catcher. Plenty of height. Here, winding up, kicking high into the dismount, straight body, two somersaults, full twist. Good work from the 17-year-old. And the score comes through 13.6. The next finalist is Nazar Chepunyi, representing Ukraine. Hopping over the bar to start, getting straight into the swing. Straight catch, Ev. There's a very high Kovac, really elevating above the bar. And the straddle catch, Ev. One arm giant. Putting in everything. Straddle catch up to mixed grip. Difficult work for a junior. There's Endo. And the double twisted. Wow. That's superb. Well done to Nazar Chepunyi. He's pleased. There was disappointment on the parallel bars, but he has come back stronger on the horizontal bar. Clearly the coach is thrilled. He nailed that routine. What a talent. Silver with the team, bronze on floor. Will it be another medal on the horizontal bar for Ukraine in the form of Nazar Chepunyi? Well, look at that, so high in the Kovac. Kicking out, keeping the spin going, keeping the form. He was determined to do well, and that he did. Turning out, winding up into the dismount. Well, great work. Superb. And the score, 13.7. He takes the lead. He's very pleased with that. And that was higher than anything that came out in qualification. Next to go, Ivan Brunello, representing Italy. Sweeping out into the handstand position. Judges looking for that vertical. There's a straight catch, Ev. And the same in the straddle position. Shoulder flexibility. Shoulder. Full twisting, double straight. Nicely landed. A good job from Brunello. Qualified with a score of 13.366. With the second highest qualifying score. Brunello, one of the older gymnasts, 17 years of age. Turned 18 in January. So this will be his final year as a junior. Good work. Kicking out. Sigh of relief. The score 13.391. He moves into third place. Four more gymnasts to go. So there are the standings. Nazar Chepunyi leads from Ivan Gibget, Ivan Brunello, currently in third place. So there are the current standings. Chipunyi still leads with 13.7 from Gugget. Brunella in third place.
Yes, gentlemen, see
the performers. The penultimate performer, Christian Balázs from Hungary. Whole of the arena behind him right now. Willing him on. In and out to handstand. Very high straight catcher. And straddle catcher. And again to mixed grip. Full turn. And a one and a half. Keeping his form, just the dismount. Full twist and double straight and nails the landing. Wow. He's laid down the gauntlet there. They are very happy with it. Fantastic performance under pressure. So, 17-year-old rising to the challenge in his home nation. Took a bronze medal on this apparatus in Buenos Aires at the Youth Olympic Games. So, what will the judges make of that? Some difficult work. Take another look. Look at this, the stooping. And up to handstand. Just very slight adjustment there. But he kept going, kept the momentum. And this, the straight catchev, feet locked together, beautiful form, and the straddle catchev. Scored 13.133 in qualification. And this, the dismount, lovely position in the air. Two straight somersaults and a full twist. Not a waver on the landing. He really did nail that. And the score coming in 13.4. It puts him into the bronze medal position at the moment with one more gymnast to go. So exciting times as Chipunyi still leads. Now then, this gymnast. Here is Lucas Desange from France, the leader from qualification. He's capable of some really good work. Can he challenge for a medal?
Lucas Desange, France.
The tension here is palpable. Oh, nice start. Stolder into the catchev and again into mixed grip. Usual entry. Endo. Half turn. Full twisting double straight, nails the landing. Well, certainly a good challenge. He's happy with it, he knows he's put in a good performance. Now then, it's over to the judges.
Gentlemen,
13.7 is the score to beat for gold. 13.4 the score to beat to get into the medals. Let's have a look. Goes into the stolder. Goes directly into the catch of that flying back straddle over the top of the bar. He repeats the skill and ends up in mixed grip. They have to do a different skill to count. They can't repeat the skill, but with it being a mixed grip to catch, that counts in terms of his difficulty. Lucas Deschange, 17 years of age. Stooping and out. Judges looking for that to come out in the handstand position, the vertical. Now the endo. He repeats it again with a half turn, favouring those straddle skills. What will it be? The anxious wait. And the score, 13.333. It's fifth place for Lucas Deschange. And the cheer goes up. They're absolutely thrilled. Hungary have got a bronze. And Ukraine take the world title. Disappointment on parallel bars, but he's rectified. Nazar Chepernyi is the new world champion on horizontal bar. Ivan Girgat from the Russian Federation takes the silver. And Hungary claim their bronze in the form of Christian Balázs. Exciting times here at the Audi Arena. So here, confirmation of the results. That bronze medal will be celebrated here in Hungary tonight, I'm sure. What an exciting close to these Junior World Championships. So we extend our appreciation to all of the gymnasts for their efforts, congratulate the medalists, and thank Hungary for what has been a truly successful championships.